all you action figure enthusiasts out there, JC here with another TNI news video. Now today is Wednesday, it is Veterans Day here in the United States, so if you are somebody who is watching this video who is currently serving or has served in the military, I just want to take a moment and say thank you for your service. Alright, now let's jump into it. As always, we've got a lot of things to cover today, and I am going to be recapping some of the news I went over in the live stream video I did earlier this week. So if you haven't watched that, well, you should, but if you haven't, I'm going to recap the news I talked about in that video. So let's go on and jump into it, and let's start off with a little bit of NECA toy news. So a couple things. So first of all, they announced that they are going to be doing an 8-inch retro cloth type figure for the movie My Bloody Valentine. So they are going to be doing the minor figure. Now, this is one of the collaborations that they often do with Shout Factory. So this is being sold on the Shout Factory website, and you can either buy the figure by itself or you can buy it with the My Bloody Valentine limited edition steelbook Blu-ray set that they're offering over there on the website. But again, if you're into that movie, you know, they are doing the minor figure, and it is an 8-inch retro type figure. NECA is also doing some Ultimate 7-inch scale 2-packs based on the Puppet Master movie, so another horror-based movie. And with this, they're doing the 2 2-packs. One will include the figures of Blade and Torch, and the second 2-pack is going to include Pinhead and the Tunneler. And both of these sets are available for pre-order at places like our sponsor Big Bad Toy Store. They cost you about $30. You know, they come with a wide range of accessories, each one. So like the set that's going to include the Blade and the Torch, with that one, you're going to get 2 interchangeable heads for the Blade figure, one with blood on it and one that is clean. You're going to get 2 knives, also one clean and one bloody. And then for the Torch figure, you get the Torch effect piece. For the other 2-pack with the Pinhead and the Tunneler figure, you're going to get 2 interchangeable sets of hands, a fire poker, a wrench, 2 hooks, and a vial of rejuvenation liquid. Then for the Tunneler figure, you're going to get the alternate bloody drill head, you're going to get an alternate hand, you're going to get a grease gun, and you're going to get the pickaxe. So as I said, both of these are available for pre-order now, and you can get them at places like our sponsor Big Bad Toy Store. Mezco today announced that they're doing an Ultraman box set for their 5-point line. So these are the smaller scale figures with 5 points of articulation. And with it, you get the Red King figure and Ultraman himself. Red King comes with a rock that you can throw at Ultraman, and Ultraman comes with an alternate pair of arms that, you know, you can, you know, the arms really don't have much articulation. So if you want to put him in a pose where he's like firing the ray out of his hand, then you'll need to switch out the arms. You also get basically a diorama for the Tatara Island that these two duked it out on, which is probably the coolest thing about this set. Now, this set is available for pre-order now at places like our sponsor Big Bad Toy Store, and the cost of it's going to be about $30. For you McFarlane Toys DC Multiverse fans, I've got a couple bits of news I want to share with you. Now, some of this, again, is recapping what I talked about in the live stream video from earlier this week. But we have our first official image of the regular release version of the Todd McFarlane-designed Batman figure. So we had already seen the gold label version that's the Walmart exclusive, which has the gray colors on things like the mask, the cape, and the boots and gloves. This regular version is going to have dark navy as opposed to gray on those things. So again, the mask, the boots, the gloves, the shorts and things will be a dark navy blue as opposed to gray. That's the main difference between the figure. And then you also get some different accessories with it. So with the Walmart exclusive version, you got some gold daggers. With this one, I think you get probably cooler looking weapons, maybe not Batman like weapons, but definitely cooler looking weapons with the spike handled knives. And both, you know, with the Walmart version and the gold knives, those would fit on the back of the figure and the cape, and these spike handled knives also will fit in the back of the figure as well. And then you can see with this image, it looks like you're going to get a gold batarang. Now, when Todd McFarlane first announced this figure, he had also shown an accessory of a grapple gun. It does not look like that grapple gun is going to come with the Walmart exclusive, and I don't know for sure if it will come with this one or not. It's not pictured here, but it's possible, you know, maybe they dropped that. It was one of those oversized grapple guns, so it wasn't really that exciting. But again, you know, with this one, I actually kind of like this one better. I pre-ordered the Walmart one, but I may end up canceling that and just waiting until this comes out. This is the regular release version. It should be available everywhere that carries DC Multiverse figures. And I really like the weapons better on this one. And even the dark navy color, I think, is pretty good. I mean, it's not a big deal between the gray and navy, but I do kind of like the dark navy. Even though it's not the best, it's kind of hard to tell with this image with the photoshopping in the background and everything. But definitely, I like those spike-handled knives better than the gold ones. Following up on a story I had previously talked about, we have a better quality image of that gold Red Death figure that is coming, which looks like it's going to be a Walmart exclusive here in the United States. This image comes from an overseas e-tailer. This figure has been going up for pre-order at overseas e-tailers in the Philippines. And so I guess they got their hands on a higher res image. This figure is listed on the Walmart website, but it's not available for purchase, and there's no images yet on the Walmart website. But again, this has been listed as a gold label collection figure, which means it will be a Walmart exclusive, and I'm pretty sure this is what the listing on the Walmart website is going to be for. So I'll put a link to the Walmart listing as well as the overseas website that had the high-res image in the comment section below. But if you want to bookmark it, if you're interested in getting it. And this isn't just as I mentioned before, this isn't just a regular gold-colored figure like we've been seeing them do for their Platinum Series line. This one is actually based on the comics. It's essentially, you know, they're taking the Reverse Flash theme and using it with the Red Death character. Red Death was red and evil. This version is gold and good, and again, this is actually something that appeared in the comics. And then finally, if you had pre-ordered that Red Hood Nightwing 2-pack and you only wanted the Red Hood figure, you might want to cancel your pre-order at Target. Now again, that 2-pack is not actually even a Target exclusive, they're just the ones that get first crack at it. But it looks like the Red Hood figure, the exact same figure from what I can tell, is going to be re-released as a single packed edition. I'm not surprised they're doing a single packed version, though I was expecting them to like change the costume to gray so it would be more comic book accurate. You know, with this one, it's all black, the actual outfit, which I like, I think looks good, but I think the gray would be more comic book accurate. But again, as it appears, and this image comes from somebody on Twitter who got their hands on it, and you know, no official announcement has yet come from McFarlane Toys about the single release or anything along those lines, but it definitely looks like that is coming. So you know, you might want to wait to the official announcement, but again, if you're just getting that Target, or not even Target, but if you're just getting that two pack with the Nightwing just for Red Hood, you might want to hold off, like I say, and wait for the single release to come. For you Star Wars fans, I got a couple of things I wanted to share with you. So first of all, the HasLab Razorcrest project has come to an end. That crowdsourcing project from Hasbro for the vintage collection Razorcrest has come to an end, and it has been fully funded along with all the stretch goals. So the last two, the display base and the vintage collection Jawa figure, are definitely going to be coming with the vehicle. And it looks like they ended up with over 28,000 backers for this project, which actually puts it on top. Previously, the Marvel Legends Sentinel had been the best backed, or you know, had the most backers than any of the HasLab projects, which had around 22,542. And with the Razorcrest here, that they are now king, I guess, of the HasLab crowdsourcing projects. And I wanted to share this funny image that was created by Bosk. He did a video about this, which you can check out. I'll put a link to his channel, and he talks about this. But I thought this image he created of the Mandalorian punching out the Sentinel was funny. Hot Toys has teased a couple more Mandalorian-based figures. They're going to be doing Moff Gideon, and they are also doing a Tusken Raider, which, of course, has been appearing in the Mandalorian series. They appeared in the Season 2, Episode 1. They were also in the first season as well. Of course, you know, Tusken Raiders have appeared elsewhere in Star Wars, but these are being billed as Mandalorian versions. And with the Moff Gideon, you can see he does come with his Darksaber, which is cool, and we should be getting more details on that in the near future. And along those lines, Hot Toys is also, for you Marvel fans, teased a new Miles Morales Spider-Man figure based on the upcoming PS5 video game. So, it's no brainer that they were going to start, they did figures for the PS4 game. Now they're going to be doing them for the PS5. And the first one they're starting off with is Miles Morales. So they released this teaser image just today, and more details on the figure should be coming soon. And while we're on the subject of the PS5 Spider-Man game, I just wanted to share these images that were released for the game, showing off some new costumes that Spider-Man will be sporting in the game. And I would not be surprised at all if we end up seeing these in figure form, either from Hot Toys or Hasbro for Marvel Legends, or both. And I'd love to hear your thoughts. Are these versions of Spider-Man you'd be interested in seeing in action figure form? Disney continues to expand their Marvel Toy Box line. So these are the 5-inch scale figures that they sell as Disney Store exclusives. And they're doing a new playset. They're doing a Hall of Armor playset for Iron Man. So I think this is actually pretty cool, one of the cooler playsets that they've done. So with it, you get an actual Iron Man figure, and then you get some attachments that you can put on the Iron Man figure, and then you get the Hall of Armor display piece, the playset, which actually folds up. I don't know if it's supposed to look like the suitcase from Iron Man 2, but that's what it reminds me of. And then you get cool packaging as well. So I don't think this would be in scale with Marvel Legends. I've seen some of you asking. I actually ordered this. It's available on the Shop Disney website. It costs about $30. So when I get it in hand, I'll take some pictures. But my guess is probably Marvel Legend figures will be too tall to actually fit in this thing. But I think, if you are into the toy box line, this is one you'll want to check out. Okay, now getting into Marvel Legends. Recapping a story I've previously talked about, last month I posted a rumored list of the remaining figures in Hasbro's Marvel Legend Power of the X-Men wave. So at the Hasbro PulseCon, they revealed three of the figures in the wave, which were Professor X with the Cerebo helmet, the Moria MacTaggert, and the Magneto in the white outfit. So all three of those figures are definitely coming in that House of X wave that they're going to be releasing early next year. But then I posted up on Marvelous News a rumor list that included Cyclops, Jean Grey, Wolverine, and Omega Sentinel. Now, I still feel very confident in this list. The only one I'm not 100% sure on is the Omega Sentinel character. I've previously mentioned how official sources told us to keep guessing when we originally posted this list. And I've done further confirmation, so I feel very confident in this list. But however, with the Omega Sentinel character, I do have to, just note that I made an assumption on the Sentinel part. The listing just simply had Omega. So it's possible, Omega Sentinel had a large role in the story, which is what made me think that's what it was referring to. But it's possible that is wrong. It could be Kid Omega, or it could even just be a reference to like an Omega powered level mutant, which is kind of a theme from that storyline. So that's the only one I'm not entirely sure. But this week, Rectangular had got his hands on an image. It's a factory sample, according to him, of the Jean Grey figure. So it definitely looks like that one is confirmed, or as near as you can get for a confirmation until Hasbro officially does so. And again, I feel very strong and confident. Not that it's really a no-brainer, but with Cyclops and Wolverine, and then the Omega character will just have to end up waiting and seeing what it actually is going to be. Also, since I mentioned this in the live stream earlier this week, I'm gonna go on and bring it up here. Another piece of intel that I've gotten earlier this week, some images surfaced online of what looked like a Marvel Legend MCU Quicksilver along with a Fox version of Quicksilver. Now, it looks very much like that image that was making the rounds on the internet was faked. It looks like somebody just took some customs and blurred up the image and tried to make it look like Marvel Legends, like an official Marvel Legends reveal. But I can tell you that intel that I have seen indicates we will be getting an MCU version of Quicksilver. It'll be part of a subline, kind of a, I don't know if how exactly they're working it, if it's like a continuation of the anniversary stuff that they did for the MCU before. Obviously, it's not still the same anniversary, but it's going to be released along those lines. And again, it does look like very much so that the MCU version of Quicksilver will be coming, well, next year, not this year, but next year. And even though that image that was surfacing was fake, I just wanted to let you guys know that. Now, as far as a Fox version, I've heard no intel. I can't sit here and say definitively they're not going to do a Fox version, but I've seen nothing that would indicate that there is a Fox version of Quicksilver coming, just the MCU version. Okay, and then the final bit of news I have for you guys today, Hasbro has announced that they are doing another live stream event this coming Friday, the 13th. It'll take place starting at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. It is a triple play Friday, so they are doing reveals for Star Wars, Transformers, and Marvel Legends. They also tease what looks like is going to be another Transformer Ghostbuster crossover. And even though not mentioned in Hasbro's announcement for the live stream, I believe there will also be some Power Ranger reveals made on Friday as well for the Lightning Collection. So based on intel that I've received, I would expect some Power Ranger news on Friday as well, even though I don't know if it'll be included in this live stream or not. But definitely Transformers, Star Wars, and Marvel Legends. If you're into Marvel Legends, I'll tell you that the reveal will be something with legs on it. That's my clue for you there. I don't know if I know everything that's going to be revealed. I certainly haven't seen. I don't have images of anything. We'll see if anything leaks out early. And then, of course, we will have full coverage as it happens on the various websites, Marvelous News, T-Formers, and Jedi Insider. We'll have the videos embedded. We'll bring highlights as they're announced for anything new, as well as images. So if you can't watch the video, and you can go to YouTube, you can go to the Pulse YouTube page and watch it, or you can come to the websites where you can get the updates and the images as well. But again, that's going to be taking place this Friday at 11 a.m. Eastern Time. And then, of course, after the event, probably later in the day, I will do another news video recapping all the stuff that is revealed. Oh, and if you're wondering, you know, about this box behind me that, well, says Hasbro on it, well, unfortunately, I can't talk about it at the moment. In fact, I can't even open it myself until next week. But what I will tell you is check back around next Friday, and I will show you what's inside there. Okay, so that's it for today. I'd love to hear your thoughts on everything I talked about. Let me know in the comments section below. Like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell notification so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. Stay safe out there, guys, and until next time, I'll catch you later.
Hey, thanks for watching today's video, and be sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and hit that bell notification so you're alerted every time I upload a new video. And be sure to head over to the Toy News International and Marvelous News message boards communities. It's a great place to talk toys and win cool contests like $100 store credits to Big Bad Toy Store. And remember, action figures are great!